Me and Meth go back 30 years. Me and Al go back 2.5. Mm-hmm. But as soon as he walked through the door, we knew. Made our contact, and we was in character. Did they have to tell us to get in character?
Nah, man. As soon as I walked through the door, he screams out, Cousin Bobby, and we basically improv for about 10, 15 minutes straight.
Yep. Jordan Peele and it was like this.
That was the audition.
And that was the audition. Yeah. All the executives were sitting there. And with Meth, me and Meth started together. Same year. He became Meth. I became Tracy. And we met Uptown Comedy Club in Harlem.
Really?
Yeah. Uptown Comedy Club.
Yeah. I was doing this shit. He was doing Meth, man.
You were going and you were a fan of the show. You were going to watch the show?
I was actually, we was going to perform. I was watching the show before we even was thought of. I was watching the show. So, you know, yeah, I was already a fan. And by the time we got there to perform, I was familiar with a lot of the people there. But Tracy definitely was a standout.
Wow.
And he was a standout for Wu.
Yeah, of course.
Yeah, that's Meth, man. So, and along that, the years go by, you know, our paths cross, and that's my brother. It's always good. Always been. I'm Wu for life. I'm just like all y'all. Who ain't Wu for life?
You on the album, in the
movie.
Come on. Who ain't Wu for life?
This brother.
I don't trust you if you're not Wu for life, to be honest.
I don't trust you. I love Wu-Tang like I love a corrupt senator. Love him. I'm not voting for you if you ain't got no sex scandal going on. Can't trust you. I can't trust you. I love corrupt senators. Trust them.
Matthew, you have there's a Wu-Tang documentary right now on Showtime. What has it been like to sort of look back over the last 30 years and the career, your career, Wu-Tang's career as a whole, and the separate careers that have gone along with it, and to watch this series?
Outside of the bad clothes, bad hairdos, and you know, I learned a lot. I learned a lot about my brothers that I didn't know, and it was emotional, some parts, especially revisiting my best job I ever had, the Statue of Liberty. Mm. Yeah, a lot of memories, man. And it's always good to sit around, to still be there 25 years later and to be able to see that and the impact that you have. And we also got a district named after us in New York City.
Yeah, well deserved.
I can say that I left something behind.
Yes,
you know?
Sir.
I mean, that's got to be the craziest feeling to have a district named after
district.
You. District. After.
Could you say that one? Because it sounds different coming from a white
dude. Yeah.
Let me hear you say district.
When you have a district named after you, Method
Man. That sounds like you got to fill out paperwork. Right? You got to fill out paperwork.
When your presence is felt not just around your people but around the world, it's bound to happen.
Yo,
no, I'm just.
Ask me where I'm going. Say where you going.
Where you going, Tracy?
I'm going up to the Wu District.
Wu-Tang District.
Yo, I gotta say this, man. Like I'm like everybody out there sitting in the audience, man. Like these are two legends, man. 25, 30 years in the game. Like, I mean, I'm just sandwiched between greatness, man. I appreciate it, man.
And you can pay your rent. That's what's up.
It's true.
That's right. That's right. Bills
are paid. Y'all can pay our rent.